या कुंदेन्दु तुषार हार धवला या शुभ्रवस्त्रावृता या वीणावरदण्डमण्डितकरा या श्वेतपद्मासना या ब्रह्माच्युतशङ्करप्रभृतिभिर्देवैः सदा वन्दिता सा मां पातु सरस्वती भगवती निःशेषजाड्यापहा शुक्लां ब्रह्मविचारसारपरमाम् आद्यां जगद्व्यापिनीं वीणापुस्तकधारिणीम् अभयदां जाड्यान्धकारापहाम् हस्ते स्फटिकमालिकां विदधतीं पद्मासने संस्थितां वन्दे तां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं बुद्धिप्रदां शारदाम् गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुःसाक्षात् परब्रह्मा तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः।
I'm Hiral Master. I'm glad that our college is celebrating its 22nd Foundation Day. Today I'm gonna talk about challenging health issue. Of course, mental health issue. We humans always have a way. I mean, at this situation of global pandemic, we managed to celebrate our occasion virtually. As a human, we have the tendency to overcome every obstacles for situation. Every human has their own unique view. And the source of this uniqueness are actually the thoughts which we pour in our mind. Thoughts can be negative or positive, but if amount of negativity in your thoughts seems increasing, it means there is something wrong, which you can't see like physical health. And that's the main reason people take it for granted. Survey shows that 1 out of 7 people in India are suffering from mental health issues. And this issue is actually high among youth, which is more than 25%. Now, talking about causes, though it differs from person to person, but the basic and major causes are digitalization and stress. Digital use can have a large impact on users' mental health. Being overly connected can cause several psychological issues. Now, stress. Stress is the leading cause for several mental health issues globally. Only in India, 89% of Indian population are suffering from stress. These issues or disorders can be anxiety disorder, depression, schizophrenia and many more. But right now, not talking about that, we'll talk about the solutions to get rid of these unlikely issues. Firstly, I would like to talk about is diet. Yes, diet. It is said that we are what we eat. And Ayurveda highly believes in this concept. What we put in our bodies reflects on our daily behavior and mood. So one can take a step ahead by simply taking a proper healthy diet. That's it. Second one, you all might have heard, or maybe some of you are doing it, which is meditation. Meditation is actually a moment of stillness and silence, which plays a very important role in our mental health. We are bombarded by noise of TV, radio, traffic, etc., etc. But among all these, the loudest noise is in our inner heads. When we meditate and have a moment of stillness, it brings awareness to these internal thoughts. And that's
when we can choose which thoughts we want to hold on to and which we want to let go of. Now, important suggestion for doing meditation is stay comfortable. It is not necessary to sit with your back straightened. It can also be done on your couch. Just stay comfortable as possible. Just 5 minutes a day will bring a huge difference in yourself. And some of you are maybe experiencing this tremendous change and guidance. But for those who are unaware, do give yourself some reward for working 24/7 consciously or subconsciously. There is one more thing I would like to add, which is stay busy. And also, psychology says that staying busy with your favorable activities or work or hobbies can have a positive impact on your mental health. You can add any other activity or exercise which you feel is beneficial for yourself. And actually, this is a long-term investment which you make for ourselves. Also, in this pandemic which we are going through, it is so important and necessary to take care of our mental health. So, be responsible and reasonable in it. I hope you all felt and understood why taking care of mental health is way more important than we think. And once again, warm wishes to all those who are connected with this college. Thank you so much.
Hello everyone, I am Manali Tuttilla. I am very happy that our college, IIAPS, Indian Institute of Pharmaceutical Science, is celebrating its 22nd Foundation Day. On this occasion, I am here to discuss about youth and drug abuse. We all must have heard that the most memorable part in one's life is when you are a youth, you are a student. Because at that time, you are very energetic, you want to try new things. But unfortunately, that is also the stage where there are chances one get addicted towards drugs, alcohol, cigarette smoking, etc. Nowadays, drug addiction is becoming a severe problem all over the world. There are many chances or reasons behind this. Because of stress, students won't be able to cope up their study pressure. There are many cases where students find lonely alone. They are not able to share their problem with their friends. They are not getting emotional support from their background. And to escape from the situation, to calm down themselves, they find drugs and soon become a drug addict. Poverty. Due to poverty also, many students are getting involved in drug selling and drug trafficking. We all know how harmful effects drugs does in our body. Drug addiction. Due to drug addiction, there are very serious and long-term consequences, including problems with mental and physical health. And it becomes very difficult for one to recover from this addiction, and it requires very long time-consuming process, and the whole future of that person gets destroyed. Government and many NGOs are working on this process to save our future generation, are making awareness programs so that they can get proper knowledge about drugs, about the adverse effects in body and everything. In fact, 26th of June has also been declared as International Day Against Drugs. We all know how harmful drugs are. And if someone get addicted towards it, it becomes very difficult for their family also and their future also. But there are many NGOs which are running to save youth, to save the future generation. I would like to request every parent to make some time for their children to look whether they need any emotional or mental support, to sit and discuss their problems with themselves. And I would also like to request students also that they should involve with their family members, with their friends. They should discuss their problem with them rather than using drug and destroying their life. There are many cases where students are using drugs and no one is knowing. If someone knows or comes to know that around them there are some person who are getting affected from drugs, then they must inform their guardians, their parents, their teachers, so that that person's life can be saved. There are many cases where many students have been recovered from this addiction, though it requires a very time consuming process, but still they are getting recovered. At last, I would like to congratulate each and everyone who are involved in the betterment of this institute. Thank you so much.
Aturasya vikar prashamanam cha charak samhita सूत्रस्थान 30/26। क्या आप आयुर्वेद का मूल उद्देश्य जानते हैं? आयुर्वेद का मूल उद्देश्य स्वस्थ व्यक्ति के स्वास्थ्य की रक्षा करना और आतुर या रोगी जो व्यक्ति है उसके विकारों का प्रशमन करना है, ऐसा आचार्य चरक ने हजारों साल पहले कहा है। समदोष समाग्निश्च समधातु मलक्रिया प्रसन्नात्मेन्द्रिय मना स्वस्थ इत्यभिधीयते सुश्रुत संहिता सूत्रस्थान 15/41। इस श्लोक में आचार्य सुश्रुत का कहना है कि जिस व्यक्ति का दोष अग्नि धातु और मलक्रिया सम रहती है, अर्थात कोई भी प्रकार की विषमता या विकृति न आए, उसको स्वस्थ व्यक्ति माना जाना चाहिए। जैसे कि यहाँ पर प्रेजेंटेशन में आप देख सकते हैं कि चार तरह के पलड़े दिखाए गए हैं, जिसमें प्रथम पलड़ा दोष का है, द्वितीय पलड़ा अग्नि दर्शाता है, तृतीय पलड़ा धातु दर्शाता है और अंतिम और चौथा पलड़ा मल को दर्शाता है। इसके अंतर्गत हम ये कह सकते हैं कि मानव शरीर में त्रिदोष, जो कि हमने पहले पलड़े में उसको दिखाया है, उसमें वात पित्त और कफ आता है, जबकि दूसरे पलड़े में अग्नि को दर्शाया है। उस अंतर्गत मानव के शरीर में 13 प्रकार की अग्नियां होती है, जैसे एक जठराग्नि हमारे शरीर में अग्नि के रूप में वर्णित किया है, सप्त धात्वाग्नि जो कि रस रक्त मांस मेद अस्थि मज्जा शुक्र गिन सकते हैं, पंच भूताग्नि जो कि पंच महाभूत है सृष्टि में उसके आधार पर निर्मित होती है। बाद में आता है तीसरा पलड़ा, उसमें धातुओं को दर्शाया गया है। जैसे कि आप सब जानते हैं कि मानव के शरीर में सप्त धातु होती है, उस अंतर्गत रस रक्त मांस मेद अस्थि मज्जा और शुक्र हम गिन सकते हैं, और अंतिम पलड़े में जो कि मल दर्शाता है, तो उसके अंतर्गत मानव के शरीर में 3 प्रकार के मल होते हैं, जो मूत्र पुरुष और स्वेद के रूप में मिलता है। यहाँ श्लोक के संदर्भ में हम देखने जाएं तो दोष अग्नि धातु और मल में आई विषमता या असमानता असंतुलन के कारण ही मानव अस्वस्थ हो जाता है, या दूसरे शब्दों में कहें तो उसके शरीर में रोग को आमंत्रण मिलता है। श्लोक के दूसरे लाइन के संदर्भ में जो भी व्यक्ति का दोष धातु मल अग्नि सर्व संतुलन में है, आत्मा इंद्रिय और मन प्रसन्न रहती है, वो व्यक्ति स्वस्थ है, ऐसा हम कह सकते हैं। उसी व्यक्ति को हम निरोगी मान सकते हैं। जैसे कि प्रेजेंटेशन में जो तुला दर्शाई है, उसके कोई भी एक पलड़े में कुछ भी असंतुलन हो, यथा दोष का पलड़ा है मानो उसमें कफ की वृद्धि हुई या पित्त की वृद्धि हुई, तो मनुष्य रोग ग्रस्त होता है, ऐसा आचार्य सुश्रुत ने हजारों साल पहले कहा था। उसको WHO ने भी स्वस्थ व्यक्ति की परिभाषा के तौर के मान्यता दी है।